Hello viewers, welcome to E-Content Development Center, Majlis Arts and Science College, Puramannur. It's me, Dhanesh Raghavan KM, Assistant Professor, PG Department of Commerce, Majlis Arts and Science College, Puramannur. Today, I would like to discuss the concept of efficient market hypothesis. After watching this video, the viewers are able to understand the concept of efficient market hypothesis, its assumptions, and the different forms of market efficiency. The efficient market hypothesis evolved in the 1960s by Eugene Fama. Fama made the arrangement that in an active market that includes many well-informed and intelligent investors, securities will be appropriately priced and reflect all available information. The efficient market theory states that financial markets are efficient. Market efficiency refers to a condition in which current price reflects all the publicly available information about a security. According to Professor Eugene Fama, in an efficient market, competition among the many intelligent participants leads to a situation where at any point in time, actual prices of individual securities already reflect the effects of information based both on events that have already occurred and on events which as of now the market expects to take place in the future. In other words, in an efficient market, at any point in time, the actual price of a security will be a good estimate of its intrinsic value. Let's look to the different assumptions of efficient market hypothesis. Following are the important assumptions of efficient market hypothesis. Information is free and quick to flow. All investors have the same access to information. Transaction cost, taxes, and any bottlenecks are not there and not hampering the free forces of market. Investors are rational and behave in a cost-effective, competitive manner for optimization of returns. Every investor has access to lending and borrowing at the same rate. Market absorbs the information quickly and the market responds to new technology, new trends, changes in taste and habit of consumers, etc., efficiently and quickly. There are three forms of market efficiency. They are strong form of efficiency, semi-strong form of efficiency, and weak form of efficiency. First one, strong form of market efficiency. The strong form of market efficiency states that the current price of stock reflects all information available. Generally, pure technical analysts believe that the market are strong form efficient and all information is reflected in the price. Second one is semi-strong form of market efficiency. The semi-strong form of efficient market hypothesis states that all publicly available information is similar or already incorporated into asset prices. In other words, work all publicly available information is fully reflected in a security's current market price. The semi-strong form of market efficiency assumes that the current price reflects all readily available information. The third form of market efficiency is weak form. The weak form of market efficiency states that the current price does not reflect fair value and is only a reflection of past prices. Furthermore, the future price cannot be determined using past or current prices. Graphical representation of efficient market hypothesis. As we know, there are three forms of market efficiency: strong form, semi-strong form, and weak form of market efficiency. In this diagram, the circles represents the amount of information that each form of the efficient market hypothesis includes. Note that the weak form covers the least amount of information and the strong form covers all information. Also note that each successive form includes the previous ones. Hope you all understood the concept of efficient market hypothesis. Thank you for watching the video. We'll be back with another interesting topic.